why is this? Why are you off and I have to work? Something just doesn't seem right here. And it's Labor Day. Let's celebrate that no one has jobs. Great day to celebrate Labor Day. And looking at our real unemployment rate, I'm pretty much sure we're not at 8%. I'm just saying. I think Shadow Stats is a little closer, coming in at, if I can measure, a little shy of 30%. Maybe if you want to take official and go right in the middle, but come on, 8%? Who are you trying to fool? I know one of my kids is working the polls. Working the polls, really? You sure? Like, Dad, not those polls. And about half the family, we were all having lunch, and they're like, oh, I'll come watch. That's funny. Us as a family, don't ever take six kids out to dinner. Whew. She also said that she's doing DoorDash. I'll tell you, with those kind of bills, right? You take six kids out, I just want a dash. What was it called back in the day? Diamond Dash? I don't know where they, you know, depends on what part of the world you live on. What part of the world you live on. But also how the government calculates, oh, hey, DoorDash? Okay, that's full employment. Oh, you're doing the polls? Oh, that's probably like four jobs. And I know the thumbnail says, beware! So I want to know, what are you guys doing? The stock market, talking about the three-day rule. You buying the dips or you not? And analysts say, they call them analysts, that Tesla is the most dangerous stock on Wall Street. So we will be taking a look at that. And if the three-day rule comes into play tomorrow, we could fall further, or actually it's tonight or this morning, depends on when you guys wake up. After hours trades, I think the rest of the world markets are doing okay. They don't celebrate job day since they don't have jobs either. And since it is Labor Day, we're going to look at some key points that sum up America's workforce today. And the rise, I'd say it's more like a tsunami of permanent job losses, which you don't count those. Oh, you guys aren't looking? We don't count you. The rise of permanent job losses is basically destroying the economic recovery that we're hoping for. We want a strong K-shaped recovery. So we got a lot to cover today. But if you like breaking news, business, stocks, stuff that can grow your bank account, would you at least just think about, maybe I want to subscribe? I will have to say it's a celebration day today because more people are subscribed than not. So that's good. It finally hit like 50.1. I can celebrate that. Yay! Thank you. So hopefully you guys are getting a nice day off today with Labor Day. Right? As a high school business teacher, they give me the day off, but I haven't had a day off in I don't know how long because you want me to come here and tell you what is going on, and I want to say thank you for allowing me to do that. It has been a lot of fun, but Tesla could be the most dangerous stock on Wall Street. Uh-oh, investment researcher says. And what I want to do is they can talk, right?
Welcome analysts, to Trading Nation. I'm Seema Modi. Tesla, take a look at the chart selling off again Thursday, extending a two-day drop after its largest outside shareholder, Bally Gifford.
Let's take a look. But before we do that, let's see, why do you say, I think his name's David, why do you say that Tesla is the most dangerous? Deadly? It's deadly or dangerous?
Yeah, no, I spent a lot of time with the bulls. I was on the Tesla Daily podcast with Rob Maurer last week going through the entire bull thesis and argument. And look, whatever best case scenario you want to paint for what Tesla's going to do, whether they're going to produce 30 million cars within the next 10 years and get in the insurance business and have the same high margins as Toyota, the most efficient car company with scale of all time, even if you do believe all that is true, the stock price is still implying the profits are going to be even bigger than that. So, you know, whatever you want to say about how they're going to compete and how they're the best car and how much market share they're going to own, the stock price is implying they're going to have anywhere from 40 to 110% market share, depending on what you think their long-term average.
All right, so now here's the question. Is Tesla a car company or is it not? So if you look at it that way, well, that's different. And also, why don't we look at the charts and see if this is even a tradable company? Actually, the only thing open right now is the lovely Bitcoin. My indicator is telling me it's a buy on Bitcoin. Well, actually, let me go away. Aha! I can't trade Bitcoin using my indicators or some things. Actually, you need to put this one in the course. I think I will do that when I'm done here. And here we are on Tesla on the 1 hour. I'm trading on the 1 hour up there. I don't have anything. There is nothing to buy. So the last was a sell right about there, somewhere in there. It was like a buy sell. We had this huge get out. That was the last one, all the way down. Now that's on the 1 hour. If I change this around to the daily, we still might be in the trade on that one. This is when I have to say, this is not trading advice. Don't listen to anything that I say. Too much risk. Just don't do it. Also, after hours, always low volume and after hours. But really soon, we're going to be... That is a lot of rocks here. I have to say that. What kind of drawing do I got? I mean, I see it. Got the whiskers. That's the best I can do. With some squiggles for an angry bunny telling you there is no buy position on Tesla. Well, right now there's not. Not to say that there will not be a swing a-coming. I also have a course on this for $200, normally $1,000 because I'm filming it. Did you hear me? I said I got to put something in there on Bitcoin. And I can't tell you how many comments in the comment section. I'm like, they're like, it's gone. Where do I click? What do I do? Like, if it says 1,000, that means it's not available. It'll be available tomorrow. I think you have like about, I don't know how long when they run out. I put a real limited amount, but all of this, I just keep filming. The only thing I don't think I'm going to do is options. Boy, you start like, everyone's like, oh, what are we doing? I'm so confused. I just try to keep it so simple. So if you want, as me being a high school teacher, I keep it simple. Keep it simple, stupid. That's it. This is what I do. It's been very effective until it's not. I love momentum. I hope you do. And someone also in the comment section, boy, I'm just triggered today, aren't I? He's like, this is a terrible time to get into the market. No, when there is big volatility swings, that is when you, well, me, not you, because you don't like risk. This is when it's going down, when it goes down and it pops back up and it goes down. I don't want flat. Well, that's a personal preference. It's like when you have companies like SoftBank. Their stock slid after it's unmasked as the NASDAQ whale. What? You SoftBank can't believe. But I like that. Give me, like, make big splashes so I can get in and I can get out. And SoftBank did give up about 5%. It was Zero Hedge that was reporting that's the one. They're the ones who's doing it. Their stock gained 33%, well, until Monday. Now they've had to give up some of their profits. I'll give it a big D. Doing it for the D. It's that darn derivatives market. $4 billion. That's what they were moving in the derivatives. And trying to explain to people the derivatives market, let's just say it's nuclear, okay? It's that big. It's so big it would just wipe out the world like a nuclear bomb. And according to the most recent data from Bank for International Settlements, also known as BS, for the first half of 2019, the total amounts for outstanding contracts in the derivatives market was about only $640 trillion. That's it. Well, teeny. $640 trillion. That's nothing, right? And to put $1 trillion into perspective, $1 trillion is in cash. Do I have any... Do you have any fake stuff laying around? This stuff right here, right? My $2 bill. Basically, from what I've told, you could take the size of this and it'll cover the state of California. That would be $1 trillion. I think there's only about $1.5 trillion of currency of these little things even around. So just put that into perspective on how big that derivative market is. And when that goes, it all goes. And since I did mention Bitcoin, and I am talking about the derivatives market, you know when you trade, like click, I should buy, click, let me put my password in. Bitcoin. On Robinhood, you really don't own Bitcoin. I know it says that you do, but you don't. The underlying asset that, let's say, Robinhood holds is Bitcoin, and you are going to trade the derivatives. Now, in equities markets, it's different because you're dealing with securities and contracts and other underlying assets. So just know, if you decide to, you Robinhood kids, you want to own a share of, you're not even owning a share, but let's say, because it's so complicated because it's cryptocurrency. But when it comes to Bitcoin, you don't own Bitcoin. If you want to own Bitcoin, you have to use like Coinbase. I was like, what? I almost said Robinhood again. Yeah, something like, am I logged in? No. Okay, yeah, Coinbase. This is, but you get hit with the fees. That's the problem. Because when, Bitcoin is traded, well, there's miners and blah, 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 but there's fees involved. That's why you can get Bitcoin for no fees. Like, that's the amount. They just get you in the end. Like, when you place orders, market orders. See, I place a market order on this. I'm going to get it. You know, I set a market, I don't want to do a market. Sorry, a limit of 10,050. Like, do not fill it unless it hits 10,050. Most Robinhood kids, right? You're just like, buy. And then how did I get it? Why did I get it for 11,000? Exactly. Now you're getting it, Robinhood kids. That is also why I use Webull. Well, two reasons. One was that, and two is the after-hours trades, which you don't have to pay for. On Webull, it is completely free as of right now. And the other thing that's free is two free stocks. Link in the description for you getting two free stocks on Webull. And also, what is my take? Johnny Bravo on BTC right now. I think the trend is down. The trend is your friend until the end. So I'm going to wait. I'm waiting. I'll pick up a little more. This is just not the time. And people are talking on Yahoo. U.S. stocks could fall further with three-day rule. This is something that people talk about. They're probably talking about it right now. You have 3 days. It's like sell off. But I'm okay. Again, trend is your friend till the end. We have not broken the 200. I think there is this the S&P 500. Yep, S&P 500. Sure. Are we S&P? Nope, we are talking NASDAQ, and they have the 50. That's the yellow line. So trend is your friend till the end. I do not see us breaking that on the NASDAQ yet. But in the video that I told you yesterday, there are four things that I look at. We did all three of them. I'm just waiting for the 200. But on this green line right here, if you break that, it is an area of concern. You come down here to this white line, or the red line, that's my 200. That's when you're frightened. And ever since we got above it, where did we get above it? Right in that area, right here. There it is, all over here. It's bull, baby, all the way. So on these swings, when they're like, oh, the market's gonna die, right? This is where it's like you buy, you sell. You get 20%, 20%, 5%, 10%, and all the way up until it doesn't. But hey, I'm just a cartoon character. What do I know? Why would you listen to a cartoon character? It's not, doesn't sound right. And I don't know how you would explain that to your wife. So you lost all your money because you listened to who? You're like, this, it's a cartoon guy, Johnny Bravo. Like, okay, that should work out well. And then another cartoon character, he is not. He's just a character. We'll be having a Labor Day conference. Wow, I tried to circle it. And I epically failed. Let's do this again. There we go. We'll be having a Labor Day news conference today. I pretty much know what you're going to say. 1 p.m. Job numbers up, better than expected. And the economic comeback looking great. Happy Labor Day. And here it is. Woohoo! This one guy is like, dude, I'm not wearing the green orange. He's from Amazon. The workforce is the best in the world since day one of my, I have been standing up for the American workforce. No one is working, my friend. And Forbes, and I, you know what? I, again, it's not very, I mean, your kings and queens are very limited in their scope. So be careful on how you worship people, 10 numbers that sum up the plight of the American workers this Labor Day. And here's the numbers, but they're just always so different. You kind of can make it whatever you want. 13.6 million. That's how many people are unemployed right now. You think so? You think it's just 14 million? And how about this one? 17%. That's the portion of August job gains that are attributed to temporary census jobs. So one of my kids is doing. Sure, that and Uber, no, the other one. Whatever. Food delivery. Here, take your pizza. Sorry if it's missing a slice. And 6.2 million, that's the number who reported that they have been laid off temporarily, right, until it is no longer temporary. 11.5 million, that's how many jobs have yet to be recovered since February, despite the modest gains. Like, all right, you can come back to McDonald's, you're fine. 8.4, that's the current, I cannot believe that. Please let me jump out of a window. 8.4, that's it. That's our unemployment rate. And since I like playing asteroids, I am going to, yep, that's not true. That's what you do. When you go to a site and you're like, that number is incorrect, so you just shoot it. It'll go away. And then you could occasionally drop a bomb, right? That is when you could just wipe out all the nonsense. What I like to do is go to the employment population ratio and go like, what's it really looking like? Back in 2000, and did you see the trend is your friend? Right into my hair. One moment, please. Let me Casper out of this for you, right? Not looking too good. And we were down there at the 50% mark until we bounced, right? Oh, you want to be a poll worker? Okay, you're fully employed. And I showed you this earlier, unemployment rate as of the Chateau stats. Whether you agree or disagree, I'll tell you that the official U3, not buying it. And here's some more crazy sauce for your pizza. Global economies are several quarters. We don't even have quarters. We can't find them. Can't get them anywhere. What's going on with our currency? Several quarters away from returning to while China will likely get there by 2020. So China's fine. So if you guys want to know what normal is like, head on over to China. They are perfectly fine. Although my confused robot friend here, right? Doesn't that look like from the movie? It just had that angry robot. Is it angry robot? He looks confused. Could it be possible that China will be cooking their books? And they're like, yep, we're great. And then Trump comes out. Oh, no, we're better. But it is the end of 2020, so we will see. Ooh, we got angrier eyes. Is it Kanye? Is it Biden? Who is it gonna be? And like always, when I go to the poll, my head always looks like this because I'm always confused. I'm like, what are my two choices again? Can I just vote for one of you? Please, please just put your name on the ballot. I will gather all my stoof together. We'll come together. Oh, the days that we are living in. But thank you guys for hanging out, making it to the very end. And it really helps everything out on the YouTube thing if you just click that button. I appreciate it. If I could, I would like you because I want to like you. I do like you. I almost knocked my mouse clear off of my stand-up desk. I just watched this thing go wing. This little guy would probably be a little pricey to fix, but... All right, guys, so we will see you tomorrow, and I will leave you with my recycled intro.